Bit of jewelry for your journey.
I die for my
people. By the divines, the Forsworn are here in the city.
Everyone stay back. The Markarth City Guard have this all under control. There are no Forsworn here. We'll handle things from here. Move along. I said move along. The Forsworn are just a bunch of madmen. We have everything under control. Stay out of it. That's right. It isn't. Mm-hmm.
What do you need? By the gods, that man nearly killed me. You saved my life. Thank you. Here. I was gonna bring this to my sister, but I think you should have it. I've heard of them. Something about the men who live in the hills and attack caravans. I'm sorry. I don't know anymore. I'm just visiting here from Cyrodiil. No. I don't have any idea. I was just shopping for a pendant for my sister back in the Imperial City. Farewell.
We'll handle things from here. Move along.
Come on in. The Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink and clean rooms. If I can't get you something, I'm sure my wife will bellow at me until I can. Of course. Of course. Take a look. Drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry. Sure thing, it's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room, right this way. Let me know if there's anything else you need.
What do you need?
How are your chores coming, my son?
clean the little reservoir.
We'll handle things from here. Move along.
That's close enough. Who are you?
Oh, it's you. I'm so glad you're here. Look, I don't know how much time we have left. My brother went down this shaft a few days ago, and I'm worried. I need you to go in after him and bring him back to me alive. It could be dangerous, but if anyone can do it, it's you. Now, are you ready? All right, but please hurry. My name's Cassia. My brother and I came to Skyrim from Cyrodiil with the Imperial Legion. But we took a break to explore these ruins. We didn't want to get involved in this stupid war in the first place. We only came here because we were conscripted. But our unit was wiped out by Nords and those Forsworn savages, and we saw a chance to get away from the fighting altogether. So, we took it. Well, we came here hoping to find something valuable to pay for carriage back to Cyrodiil. Altrius went down the shaft, but he asked me to stay here. Because he made me promise I'd stay here and wait for him, no matter what. And I keep my promises. Well, except as far as the Legion is concerned. I was in Markarth looking for help, when I heard people talking about you and all the loot you've been trading with merchants all over Skyrim. I figured you'd be interested in exploring these ruins, so I asked a courier to track you down. And here you are! So you're ready to go now? I knew I could count on you. Now quickly, go!
If you are reading this, you stand at the entrance to an ancient dwarven city. No doubt you have never heard of it, for in all my travels and all my study, I have never read of it in any text, save for the inscription here. It reads, "Those who seek refuge will find peace here, basking in the sun under the ground. Those who seek gold will find riches beyond imagining, but will pay for this folly with their lives, for there is no return to the world of man. Is it possible there is life down there? Is it possible the dwarves are still alive after all this time? As I stand here on this precipice, war raging all over Tamriel, my mind is made up. Today I take a leap of faith. Beloved reader, perhaps one day you will join me. Consider this an invitation or a warning."
To whoever reads this, I am so sorry you had to find me like this. And worse, that you will share my fate. I have spent a lifetime in this place, going around and around in circles, searching for a way out. But there are only two choices. Death, or the door to the house on the lake. I made the mistake of opening that door. I thought I could help them if I found the right one, but whatever I did, it took me right back to that lake house. In the end, all I learned is that some things are worse than death. I urge you to learn from my mistakes. Best to take your own life now, than find out what awaits you beyond that door. I've locked it and hidden the key. I'll guard it with my eternal soul if I have to. But I fear even that will not be enough. for the Lake House calls to you. And when it does, you must not listen. Altrius. I was in your shoes once, a lifetime ago. I remember the way the Lake House calls to you. Die in here alone, or do I want to open that door? Seems like a simple choice, and yet, in the end, death was the better option all along. Please, understand. I locked the lake house door to stop you from making the same mistake I made. Now, you ignore my words and come searching for the key.
7 years ago, I discovered this wondrous city uninhabited. Others soon followed, heeding my invitation, and our community grew and prospered under my rule. But as I write this, I am alone once again, for my subjects have been the victims of an unspeakable atrocity. This is why, at the expense of my own life, I must open a portal that will take you into the past, before all this began. Beloved reader, you must go back, investigate what set this atrocity in motion, and prevent it by any means necessary.
You there? Where did you come from?
Strange. It looks like you just came out of the Jarl's private lake house.
A what? Oh, I see. You're a little bit crazy. Well, you're in good company here, my friend. Lots of us weren't thinking straight when we arrived. It's the first day of last seed, I believe. I guess you hit your head pretty hard coming down the shaft, huh? It's the 194th year of the Fourth Era, of course. Look, you seem a little... you know. So I'll make this nice and simple for you. Live by our laws, and we'll all get along just fine. Don't hurt anyone, don't steal anything. Same as anywhere else. Only the punishment here is much, much worse. The Jarl can tell you more and help you get settled in. Might even have some quarters for you. I can take you to him if you like. Follow me. So this is our farmland where we grow all the food you'll ever want. As long as all you ever want is leek, cabbage and potato. If you have goods, the merchants at the market up ahead will be happy to see you. Most of us have few belongings, just what we brought in with us.
Morning, Gulvar.
Morning, Nismar. Above us is the sun under the ground. It's strange and no substitute for the real sun, of course, but these days it doesn't bother me.
What bothers me is the Citadel folk. Take Jormund, for example, standing up there on his balcony looking down on us. Just look at him.
Yeah, Jormund, you're a really big man, aren't you?
Milk drinker.
Aren't you going to introduce me to your strapping new friend, Gulvar?
We're on our way to see the Jarl. There'll be time for you to get your claws into our friend here later.
I look forward to it. You should come for a drink at my tavern, the Golden Sentinel, tonight. Just about everyone's there after dark.
Be careful with Rastasia. She...
well, it's not my place to say. There's enough gossip in this place as it is. It's a small city, after all.
Only 24 of us at the moment. 23 if you don't count Brandis, who's halfway to the next life. Luki's barely managing to keep him alive.
Hope this one's healthy. Last thing I need is another
I trust you're on your way to speak with the Jarl.
Well, you never know, do you? Every new person who arrives in this place could be a welcome addition.
This is the Citadel, where the Jarl and his guests live. If you manage to worm your way in with them, you might get to live here too.
Gulver, what do you think you're doing? You're meant to be working the Jarl's farm, not trudging dirt into his Citadel.
Jormun, take it easy, would you? I was just showing our new friend here to the Jarl.
Well, how about you get back to work, and I take our new friend the rest of the way? If you don't work, none of us eat, Gulver. Remember that.
How could I forget? Fine, I'll get back to work.
It was nice meeting you, my friend. Stop by for a chat anytime you like.
I'm sorry about that. That probably sounded a bit harsh, but it's my job to make sure we all have enough to eat. I'm Jormund. Let's head up to the next floor then, shall we? Stay close behind me. Wouldn't want you getting lost now, would we? It's good to see a new face here. Haven't had any new arrivals in a while. Since Marius. But he mostly keeps to himself. Bit secretive, actually. Most people are pretty friendly though. And so they should be. This is the closest you'll get to Sovereign Guard in all of Tamriel. No crime, no conflict. Most folk don't even bother locking the doors. Even if you could steal something without breaking the dwarves' law, it's not as if you could sell it to anyone here.
You wouldn't want to keep the Jarl waiting, would you?
Always got her nose buried in a book, that one. Helps out Brawl down in the city, our resident expert about the history and laws of the Dwemer. Last I heard, they were trying to track down some dwarven artifacts. You should ask Brawl about it, if you're into that sort of thing. This is the Citadel kitchen. Remember to be polite to our cooker Sanchi. She does the best with what she has, which isn't much. Now let's head up to the Jarl's floor. Alright, so we're about to meet Jarl Metellus. There's a couple of things you should know about him, if you want to make a good impression. First, he was the first one here. Well, he was here before the rest of us anyway. So the Citadel is his, and we're all his guests. Second, be protective of this place, and won't tolerate anyone disturbing the peace. So be on your best behaviour, and you should be fine. This is the top of the Citadel. The bathhouse is off limits, and I'm not even sure what's behind the gold door. Only the Jarl has ever gone in there. Alright, you're on your own from here. I've got lazy farmers to supervise. Good luck with the Jarl. And I'll see you around.
The Jarl's waiting for you on his balcony, on your left. What? Did you say something to me? No use talking to me, young'un. Can't hear a word you're saying. Both me ears went years ago. Still got my one good eye, though. All I need. Used to be a vigilant of Stendar till I slipped up. You take it from me. You ever find yourself toe-to-toe with a flame Atronach? You make sure you put some distance between you before you kill it. Otherwise, whoosh! Eyes, ears, and hair gone, all at the same time. Didn't catch a word. And I'll be honest, being deaf ain't half so bad as you'd think. No one bothering you, asking questions. Still can't hear ya.
There's a face I don't recognize. Welcome to my city. I'm Jarl Metellus. Tell me, what is your name? It's always exciting to meet a new member of our small community. Now, before I forget, since you're here for good, you'll need some quarters. Here's a key to the last vacant chambers down in the city, between Brawl and Luki. It's all yours. Now tell me, what brings you to my city?
I sent you here.
I'm not sure what you mean. Well, let's see. This is my handwriting. The victims of an unspeakable atrocity. I will open a portal that will take you into the past. You must go back. This is real, isn't it? I've even toyed with the idea of creating a portal between two points in time, with Brawl's help. But that's odd. My letter makes no mention of what caused the disaster. I suppose I was in a hurry. So tell me, what's going to happen to us? That's exactly what I saw when I first discovered this place, several years ago. It seems whatever happened then is going to happen again. I think it has something to do with the dwarves' lore. This is bad. This is very, very bad. Yes, you see, the dwarves who built this place left inscriptions. Brawl hasn't been able to fully translate them, but we understand some parts. This warning keeps coming up. The many shall suffer for the sins of the one. We think that breaking the law here will cause some kind of event. The truth is, I've used the dwarves' law to frighten my people into obedience. And it's worked, so far. But someone's about to break that law. Let me think. Your arrival here is exactly what I need. You've helped me a great deal by bringing this note to my attention. I wonder if you could do me another favor. I need you to investigate the city, talk to my people, help them, if it'll win their trust. You can even go through their possessions, if you have to. You must work out who is going to break the dwarves' law. Once you have a name, come back and tell me immediately. As Jarl, I authorize you to go anywhere you need to go, including private homes. But if someone asks you to leave, you should do so immediately. I can't promise either of those things, but I will certainly do everything within my power to help you, once you've helped my people. And of course, if you decide to stay, I would make sure you enjoy a comfortable life here. Now what do you say? Will you help me? Thank you. Now, you mustn't tell anybody where you're from or what may be about to happen here. People do foolish things when they panic. If it helps you, you're welcome to borrow the book on my desk. It contains the names and addresses of my subjects. Just don't show it to anyone. Goodbye for now, and good luck. I don't need to tell you what will happen if you fail.
Hello there.
I'm a Breton from Hyrak. I've studied history at the Imperial City, which led me to Skyrim in search of Dromor ruins. And now I'm here. Some days I just can't believe my luck. Working with Brawl, researching the richest source of Dremor history and technology I could have imagined. I feel like we're on the brink of some amazing discoveries about the Dremor. Who knows, maybe we'll find not all of them have disappeared. I could, but Brawl knows much more than I do. You should be able to find him in his chambers down the city. A way out of here? Are you kidding? Why would I want to get out of here? I can't think of a single place in all Tamriel I'd rather be. Now that you mentioned it, I do. I need you to get something for me, and it won't be easy. I've tried everything I can think of, and still nothing. There's a big Nord living down in the city called Rykus. You may have seen him walking around in an immaculate example of Dwarven armor. I need that armor. It's the only one like it, and I believe it to be crucial in unlocking the secret of this place. The trouble is, before I could get a good look at it, that brute Rykas claimed it as his own, and has been wearing it ever since. I've tried everything. Appeals to his better nature, flattery, charm, even threats. It's like negotiating with a brick wall. The only thing I haven't tried is violence, and you know how that would end. But I'm convinced there's a way to get it. There has to be. Thank you. If you do manage to get it, you're welcome to keep it. I just need to have a quick look at it, that's all. Of course, I think I can teach you a thing or two.
Working hard. My story. Well, I'm from Markarth originally. Started working at Kolskega Mines as a lad. And after a while, the Silverbloods made me foreman. I was doing pretty well for myself, until somebody decided to knock me down the shaft into this place. I had a wife and son. Still up there, I suppose. Though, they probably think I'm long gone. But, chin up, right? Meanwhile, I'm stuck down here, supervising workers to earn me keep, waiting for the day that I can get out of here and back to my life in Markarth. I wish. Seems like dwarves designed this place to keep folk in. But the only thing that keeps me sane is thinking there has to be a way out. Well, I'd be lying if I said they're happy, but I'd also be lying if I said I cared. They're decent people and all, but they seem to have an hard time grasping that somebody around here's got to work the farms, or we all starve. Gulver's the worst of the lot. Seems like a decent man at first, but he's got a temper on him. Once he told me he killed a man, before he came here. He'll tell you, if you ask him. Of course, down here with the dwarves, though, a bad temper could land us all in a lot of trouble. I'd keep an eye on that one, if I were you. All right, well, I'll see you around. working hard.
There's a looter coming into the city. I saw a man come down the shaft, but he was armed and he looked like a looter. If he makes it into the city and starts attacking people, he'll break the dwarves' law. And who knows what will happen? You have to stop him. Everybody, go home and lock your door. Is it over? Is it safe? Oh, thank the gods. What a relief. We're so lucky that you arrived in time to stop them. I'll be sure to tell everyone what you've done for us. Thank you so much. If there's ever anything my husband Tabik and I can do to help you, just ask. Oh, there's not much to tell. My husband Tabik runs the clothing store in town. You should stop by. I'm sure you'll leave looking much better. Not that you don't look good now, I mean. It's just, you know, nice clothes are... Oh, who am I kidding? I'm no good at selling anything. I guess that's why they've got me sweeping the floors day in, day out. Well, that and we weren't invited to be layabouts in the Jarl's Citadel. Did you see anyone working in the Citadel? I'll bet you didn't. They just amuse themselves all day while those of us down here do all the work. And why? Because Habik's a Redguard and I'm a Breton. I bet if we were both Imperial, it'd be a different story. The worst part is we left Solitude to get away from bigoted Nords after our son died. But here, the Imperials are even worse. Of course. Oh! No offense, but I'd rather not talk about it. Too many painful memories. And besides, there are enough sad stories around this place as it is. But if you're interested, you can talk to my husband, Habik, in his shop, Firefly Finery. What would we do? Start a rebellion? No way. Not after the dwarves' warning. You know, the many shall suffer for the sins of the one, and all that. I'd be a fool not to. If you're not convinced, you should go and talk to Brol in his chambers. He knows more about the dwarves than anyone. All right. Quintus? No, there's no one by that name here. But if you're looking for an Imperial, I'd check the Citadel. That place is crawling with Imperials. If I did, Habik and I probably wouldn't be here. But Ulrin's wife managed to escape a while back. He doesn't like to talk about it, but you might be able to get him to open up, I suppose. Nice to talk to you. See you soon.
You there. Come over here. I'm beyond help. The potions do nothing. And I don't have much time. I just need to tell you something. Stendar, he plants these images in my head. He shows me secrets. Made me come here. Something terrifying. Deep in the earth beneath the city. Powerful. And evil. I went down into the tunnels to destroy it. But the energy. It seeps into your bones. Please. Please, you must find a way to get down there. And finish what
I. You're the one who killed all those bandits, aren't you?
gods, what a nightmare that must have been. What do you want with me? I don't see why I should share it with you. Well, she's not here anymore. That's all I know. How should I know where she went? I woke up one morning and she was just gone. Didn't say goodbye, didn't take anything with her. And now you people won't stop harassing me, judging me, asking me questions like you think I had something to do with it. Well, I didn't. And nobody cares that I've lost my wife. They just love a bit of scandal, or to find out how they can get out of here too. You're all animals. All right. Please, let me know if you hear anything about Maisie.
Oh, hello there. That's fine. I've got a lot of reading to do if I'm going to know half as much as Grawl one day.
Hey, what can I do for you, my friend? You wouldn't believe how often the new ones ask that question. But I'll tell you the same thing I tell everyone else. There are much worse places to live out your days. You might have a few sleepless nights thinking about the dwarves' lore. But once you get used to the fear, knowing that a single slip-up could cost you everything, it's not too bad. Nothing new to me, anyways. The many shall suffer for the sins of the one. And that's about all I know. You should go and talk to Brawl in his chambers if you want to know more. Well, come on back anytime you like.
Hello, neighbor. I understand we have you to thank for dispensing with some would-be looters. So, thank you. Hello, neighbor. Would you like to hear about my research? Ah, yes. Most dwarven armor you see these days is quite badly worn. But this piece is still perfect, after thousands of years. It also seems to have some magical properties. It should protect you from the harmful energy down in the tunnels below the city. It all but killed Brandis when he went down there. But he didn't have a full set. If you can get down there safely, let me know what you discover. Time travel. You know, as it happens, I do. It was a great obsession of mine for years after my wife passed. I thought if I could go back, I gave up on that idea a long time ago. But recently the Jarl has asked to see my research notes. How strange that you should now take an interest too. Can I ask what the nature of your interest is in this unusual subject? I don't quite know what to say to that. How can I put this charitably? Perhaps you're tired and emotional and need some rest. But I always enjoy discussing my theories with a receptive mind, so I'll humor you. What did you want to ask? For argument's sake, if you found yourself in that position, you'd have only two options: to live out your days in the past, or force a paradox. A paradox, you see, would involve changing the past so as to prevent the events which caused you to travel back in time in the first place. But you'd be taking a big risk by doing that. Who knows what the consequences would be? Some say that whatever you do, it will lead you right back to the future that took you back in time in the first place. An eternal loop, if you will. But me, I believe that creating a paradox should fling you back to your original time, having changed the past for you and everyone else. Well, let's say for argument's sake that you really have traveled here from the future. You could create a paradox in a few different ways. Essentially, you could do anything that would remove your means or motivation to return to the past. For example, you came here to achieve some goal. Achieving that goal would mean you will never have been motivated to come here. A paradox. Or, if the thing that allowed you to travel back in time is still here, as a past version of itself, you could simply destroy it, I suppose. That would mean, of course, that you will never have been able to travel back in time. Another paradox. But doing so could have terrible consequences. But if you really are from the future, as unlikely as that is, telling me or anybody else what happens next could have disastrous consequences too. I think it's best if we talk about something else. That is the sun under the ground. Or at least that's how it's referred to in the Dwarven text we've managed to translate. I must confess, I haven't the faintest idea of how it works. But it seems to be giving us light and allowing us to grow crops, even under the ground. Of course, if it ever stops glowing, for whatever reason, we'll all be in quite a lot of trouble. But don't concern yourself with such dark thoughts. I'm sure we have nothing to worry about. Well, the dwarves who built this city left inscriptions in the citadel, which translate to, "The many shall suffer for the sins of the one." My research leads me to believe that if a single member of our community sins, it'll trigger an event, killing us all. I believe such an event occurred some years ago, which is why Metellus found the city littered with burnt corpses. But to this day, there are many questions we simply don't have answers for. How is the Dwarf's Law still being enforced? How does it work? And we may never know, as long as nobody attacks or steals from anybody else. Until we know more, we all need to be on our best behavior. My story? What a strange question. You presuppose that my life is a simple linear sequence of events which can be summed up in a verbal narrative? Well, that's nonsense, of course. First, most of it was so long ago I barely remember. Second, you would have to assume that the account I give you is biased heavily in my favor, and is therefore quite unreliable. And finally, my story is really much less interesting than this mysterious place. Now, do you have any sensible questions, or can I get back to work? Well, why didn't you say so? I research Dwarven history and technology, and I'm originally from Cragganmore in Morrowind. Any other questions? Now that's an interesting question. I personally don't know any way out, no. However, I have a theory. It's more of a hypothesis, really. My thinking is that if there was a way out of here, the dwarves who built this place must have known about it. True, but we can learn all sorts of things about them from what they left behind. Inscriptions, architecture, relics, statues. And while I've discovered many things here, there are some parts of the city I haven't been able to get to. I'm most interested in the palace, above the lake. Unfortunately, it's sealed up tight. Only one man ever managed to enter, and he never came out. That was Narnabas, and we haven't heard from him in years. Strange fellow. I believe he was looking for the secrets of the dwarves too. If you could find a way in there, I'm sure it would tell us a great deal about this place. Who knows what secrets we could uncover? Very well. Come back if you think of any questions about something you discover.
Thank you. Ah, the bandit slayer. Good. Yes, my friend. My story. Well, my name is Deglund, and I'm a merchant, yeah? But people say to me, Deglund, they say, Deglund, why are you a merchant? They find it surprising because I'm such an honest and trustworthy person. And sometimes you hear about your merchants who are, you know, dishonest. Well, I say to those people, I'm not like them. My father used to say to me, Deglund, you can't be like the others. You be a good boy. And I was, my friend. I was not only just a good boy. I was the best boy. The best boy now and the best merchant with the best prices for you. My friend, you're in luck. I actually do, but let's keep it down, eh? Don't want anyone else to hear, do we? But I'll be honest with you, my friend. I'm looking after you. There's a bit of a catch. See, it's only gonna work for one person, yeah? I've been keeping it to myself, you know, thinking maybe I'll need it myself one day. But I'm a reasonable guy, yeah? I reckon I could be, what's the word, persuaded? Persuaded to give it away for, say, 1,000 gold coins? My friend, I can tell you it involves magic. Very special and very rare magic. But I shouldn't say any more than that. I need to eat, you know. Well, I like you, so I'm going to be honest with you. Business here, it's hard, you know. Really hard. I'm doing it tough, yeah? And if I don't have the coin to pay the Jarl, then I lose my shop. I'm out in the cold. I have no money and no food, yeah? What I'm saying is, I need the money, my friend. That's all I need. Fair enough. All right. See you again soon, my friend.
Heard you got to kill those looters. Wish I could have joined you. I have... Get out of my face, milk drinker. My problem is that I'm the only one around here whose head isn't buried in the sand.
That's my problem. I mean, everyone acts like nothing's wrong, but we're one stupid mistake away from being wiped out, like the last lot of people who lived here. Seems like I'm the only one ready for what's coming, whatever that is. And when it hits, it's every man for himself. You've been warned. I don't know, but did you ever get the feeling these statues are watching us? Like they're waiting for something? I don't like it. What about it? Not my problem. Oh, well, in that case, you still can't have it. Let me be clear. The only way you'll get this armor is if you peel it from my corpse. It's not for sale. Nope. This is the only one like it in the whole city. Not going to happen, maggot. Because you know, and I know, that the first blow that gets landed is going to get us all killed. You're not that stupid. Not my problem. Uh-huh. What do you want? What do you want? If I did, I wouldn't be standing here listening to you. Bye.
Oh, hello. Name's Castellus Vitus, military engineer of the Imperial Legion. Out of action right now, but don't worry, I'm still in the service. What about you? Now that's just the sort of cowardly nonsense I'd expect from a Stormcloak sympathizer. Off with you then. Go on. Go bother somebody else. Well, I suppose you're right. But don't think that friendship will last if we ever get out of here. You understand that, right? Spit it out, then. Ah, yes, my workshop. Well, of course, as an engineer through and through, I couldn't resist the urge to dismantle some of this dwarven technology. How complicated can it be, I thought. As it turns out, it's extremely complicated. You see these gleaming dwarven busts in every room? Well, I think I know what they are. They all seem to be connected to the pipes running all over the city and down the front of the citadel. And I've seen these things before in other ruins, but these are different. Their eyes are glowing with blue light. Have you noticed? But whenever you see one of these things, remember, someone or something is watching everything you do, waiting for you to break the dwarves' law. Suspicious behavior, you say? Ah, so the Jarl has found a task for you, keeping tabs on us, Don't worry, your secret's safe with me, friend. well, the Citadel's mainly full of good Imperial stock, so you don't have to worry too much about them. But now that you mention it, lately I've been wondering if the Citadel isn't haunted. Every now and then, mostly late at night, I swear I can hear a woman sobbing. I'll be damned if I know where it's coming from, but it's not Gaia next door, so who could it be but a ghost? Gods know a lot have died in here. Yes, well, not completely. A little. I think I understand the pipes that run all over the place. See, they mainly carry water. There's a single pipe on the top floor bringing water from outside the Citadel inside. Water then trickles down through each floor to the lake. But that's not all. It seems the water flowing through these pipes causes these gears to rotate. And when that happens, they somehow create light. The dwarves were brilliant engineers. I doubt I could hold a candle to them. Not that I would need to with all the lights in this place. Jarl's got me working on repairs to the Citadel. This place was built to last, but it still needs an engineer's touch every now and then. Door hinges need to be oiled, cracks need to be patched up, and that bloody water pipe in the bathroom is constantly springing a leak. But it's a good idea to make yourself useful around here. No doubt the Jarl will make good use of your skills too, whatever those might be. Right you are.
What do you want?
I heard you took down some bandits.
Wish I could have sunk my axe into one of them.
Hello there, friend.
Well, it's a sad one. But I don't mind telling it. Name's Gulvar. I'm a farmer. Always was. Grew up on a farm near Whiterun. It was a good life. Fresh milk and eggs every day. Running around the farm barefoot with my brother and sisters. Never even had to lock our doors. One day, when I was about 18, my father and I were carting some produce into the market when we saw a group of strangers in the top field. My father told me to run back to the house and get his axe. So I did. I ran so fast I almost threw up. But by the time I got back, it was too late.
I found him dead by the side of the road. The cart and all our produce was gone. That was the first time I learned about bandits. My mother passed soon after, and I took over the farm. Now, I'm as good a farmer as any, and better than most, but Things went downhill from there. The raiding started before long. I'd come outside at dawn and find a few chickens missing. Next it was a cow, then two cows. That was the first time in 5 generations my family started locking its doors at night. We knew the guards from Whiterun weren't going to help us. One night, when we had nothing left to steal, there was a knock at the door. I knew who it was and what they wanted. I took my father's axe and pulled the door open real quick. Before he knew it, that bandit had my father's axe right down the middle of his skull. But there were more of them. I never saw how many, because the next thing I knew, I was waking up with a mouth full of dirt and lungs full of smoke. My home was burned to rubble. My family slaughtered like cattle. And they left me alive to see what they'd done. It still burns whenever I think about it. Well, at least I got one of the bastards. Cleaved that grin of his right in half. Sometimes it helps me get to sleep at night. Sometimes. Anyhow, after that, I drifted some. Took odd jobs around Falkreath. But nothing seemed to work out. And then I guess I got desperate. I started taking things. Just small things. Carrots, cabbages. Just enough to survive. I wasn't proud of it. And then one day, I watched myself break into some guy's farmhouse and help myself to his things. And I guess I realized what I'd become. Next thing I knew, I was looking for a place to die. And I found the entrance to this place. And that shaft. And I started my life over again. Well, I'm a farmer, but the land I work isn't mine. Metellus had declared himself Jarl and claimed all the farmland before I got here. I'm not. All I've ever wanted is to make a living by working the land. But it seems someone always has to go and steal the fruits of my labor. That bloody Jarl is no better than the bandits who destroyed my life. Only difference is he uses words instead of weapons. But he'll get his. One day. Just do me a favor and keep that last part to yourself, would you? Fair enough. See you around.
I heard you took care of some looters for us. I'm so glad you decided to come see me. What can I do for you, sweet thing? Did you notice the big crack in the floor near the city gate? They say some poor fool fell to his death trying to scale the front of the citadel. Did you know there are tunnels running all the way under the city? Last one to go down there was Brandis, and it sent him to his deathbed. Have you seen Rygus? Walking around in that shiny armor of his all paranoid, like those dwarven statues are going to spring to life any minute. Nobody here locks their door, except the Jarl. I hear there's a locked room on the top floor of the Citadel, but nobody's seen what's inside. There's something creepy about Marius up in the Citadel. Plus, he never comes down to the tavern. And you just can't trust a man who doesn't drink. Did you know that beautiful palace above the lake is sealed? Brawl says the last person to go in there locked it behind him. I wonder what's in there. You want to hear about little old me? Aren't you adorable? But wouldn't you rather hear what I know about everyone else around here? Go on. Ask me. Take a good look. See anything you like? Oh, so soon? Well, you know where to find me, honey.
Heard you held back an invasion all on your own. That's fine work.
What is it? I'm sorry, what's my story? What an oblivion is your story? How dare you come in here like you own the place and expect me to explain myself to you? I don't care who you are, but pay attention. There's a pecking order around here, and I'm at the top of it. After the Jarl, of course. So work hard and do what I tell you, or you'll wish you'd died and gone to oblivion. Got it? That's more like it. Now that you know your place, you're going to do something for me. I want you to retrieve something for me. It's a helmet. Dwarven. Made thousands of years ago. But still in immaculate condition. One of those Vigilants of Stendar had it with him when he went down into the old mine tunnels over by the lake. He never came out. I want you to go down there and bring it back. Now, do you have any questions? Now there's a good peasant. Go on now. And don't you show your face in the Citadel again without it, you understand?
Hello again, my friend.
Working hard.
Yes, my friend.
Friend.
I hear you're handy in a fight. Glad. My story. Oh, not much to tell, love. I just work the land, make sure we've got enough food for everyone. Can't afford to run out here, you know? It's hard work. Probably harder than being Jarl. But I don't mind it. Keeps me active as I'm getting on a bit. And I sleep soundly every night. No, love. I don't think he works hard at all. And I'd say the same to his face if I ever saw him. But he's always hiding up there in his citadel, doing... You know what? I'm not even sure what he does. I know he doesn't keep order. We've got the dwarves' law for that. But live and let live, I say. Long as I have a roof over my head and food on my table, and good neighbors like Gulvar, I can't complain. Oh, come on, love. It's not that bad, is it? You've only just arrived. Why not give the place a chance before you go looking for a way out? Well, I'm sorry you feel that way, but I'm afraid I don't know if there's a way out or not. Now that I think about it, you might want to talk to Degland over at the Honest Trader. Offered to sell me a way out a while back, but his price was steep. Up to you. Bye for now.
Hello there, friend.
I hear you.
Hello, dear.
Oh my, it's very nice of you to take an interest in my life, dear. But you don't need to humor an old woman. Really? Well, you're the first person in the city to say that. Well, let's see. These days, I mostly just sweep the streets here, keep them clean. Cleanliness is next to godliness, or so they say. It's not very inspiring, as you can imagine, but the alternative is to wind up like poor Dooley. Oh, you haven't met him yet. Don't worry, I'm sure he'll introduce himself to you sooner or later. He's homeless. He lives in a cave by the lake. I feel sorry for him. I think most of us do. But ever since his brother died, he's been obsessing over some long-lost treasure. The Jarl decided because he can't work, he doesn't deserve to live in a house like the rest of us. So he lives in a tent, in a cave of sorts. But don't let him drag you into it. I'm quite sure it's imaginary. A great loss can do terrible things to a person's mind. Well, anyway, that's about all there is about me to tell, I'm afraid. I'm not very interesting. Oh, well, goodbye.
Hello again, my friend.
Can I help you with something?
What can I do for you, my friend?
No, hello there.
Hello. I wasn't following you. My what? My story? Oh, do you want to hear about me? I'm sorry, but my memory's not very good. I only remember some things. I came here with my brother, Harrible. He used to look after me, and he said he always would, but then he died. Now nobody looks after me. I'm not very good at remembering things. Sometimes I forget, so I need help. That's why I need some help finding Harrible's treasure. Well, my brother told me before he died that he had left me something very precious in a secret chest. He hid it away just for me. I've asked the others for help, but they don't help me. The Yard even wrote me this letter, but I'm not very good with words. Here, do you think you could read it for me? Tell me what it says. Well, what does it say? You did? Oh, thank you. What does it say? What? No, that can't be right. My brother, he told me. He told me he left me a fortune. He would lie to me. Why would he lie to me? You'll help me, won't you? You'll help me find it, please. Thank you. All I know is that it's hiding somewhere in the city. And you need this rusty key. My brother gave it to me to unlock it. I can't. Sorry. I don't remember things so good, but he said it was hidden under the ground and that I have to hold my breath. That's all I remember. Oh, all right.
Stop right there. What is this one doing here? Ah, the locked chest. Yes, we have it, but have been unable to open it. Why don't you come in and join us for dinner? Very well, but hurry. We are hungry. We are explorers like you. We were exploring the bottom of a great mine when we found this cave. But just as we found it, the earth shook and the mine collapsed behind us. This is our home now. We are pleased to see someone in the flesh. My siblings and I, don't worry, we will all share in your company. We are not sure. A lonely tower sitting all by itself in a forgotten pocket of the earth. It is strange, is it not? So curious this one is. We have been here for years, surviving on fish and this wondrous mushroom, and whatever else we can scrounge up. We found it in the water down below, but we could not unlock it, so we dragged it up here. It is locked away in the lonely tower. Good, good. This one asks many questions. Now, let us eat, It is wise not to trust us. But the wise ones taste just the same as the foolish. Into our lair! Wait! My sister, so hungry! Into our lair. We just wanted to feed.
Oh, hello. Yes, what about it? You did? What was in it? A key. Harrible left me a key. I'm confused. It was supposed to be something valuable, but it's just a key. What do we do with the key? Oh, all right. Maybe there's a treasure in there. A big pile of gold coins and gemstones. Maybe you could even share some of it with me.
Can I help you with something? So my wife disappears a couple of weeks ago, and now everybody thinks I know a way out of here. I wish you idiots would just leave me alone. See you later.
Hello again, my friend.
Well, I'm still waiting for that immaculate helmet.
Hello, dear.
Oh, gods, not again! Please don't hurt me! Thank the gods! Quickly, you have to let me down before that monster comes back! Okay, but please hurry! Of course it is! But I think the dwarves are blind to whatever happens in this room. You can see the dwarven bust over there got broken somehow. I'm going to kill that monster who calls himself Jarl. I'll scratch out his eyes with my bare hands if I have to. That sounds like the sort of thing Metallus would do. Make it look like I was dead so Ulrin would stop looking for me. That bastard! So, you'll let me go then? What? Why not? So you're just gonna leave me here? What? No, that's not... Please don't leave me here. Please. I'll do anything. Please don't leave me.
My eye on ya.
Ha
Hello again, my friend. Any word about the matter we discussed? Well, I hope your investigation has been thorough. I don't want you accusing the first person you suspect. So, who is it?
Hey, keep your voice down. Do you want to get us all killed?
Look, you might have noticed we're being watched by the dwarven statues everywhere you look. But I managed to break the bust in that room. So in there is no dwarves' law. Understand? What happens in my private room stays there. Because if my little secret gets out, then you and everyone else in this place is going to suffer badly. What you do next is up to you. You can keep your mouth shut, in which case we all live. Or you can let her go, in which case we all die. I promised you no such thing. I said I'd do everything in my power to help you. But here's the thing. There is no way out of here. You're stuck here for the rest of your life. Now get out of my citadel. I'm bored of you.
My father told me what you did to those Lutons. He says you're dangerous.
What do you want? Bye.
I see you found some more immaculate armor. Not bad.
We can talk, but be quick. Domitus could be back any second.
I'm Saphira. I'm from Markarth, from a part called the Warrens. If you've never gone there, don't. Just don't. About a year ago, I met a guy there. Said he was there for business. Nobody has any business being in the Warrens. But he had coin, and when he saw me, I saw a way out. Long story short, I followed him here. The more I think about it, though, I would have been better off in the Warrens with the beggars and skeevers. Guess you haven't met him, huh? Take my advice. Stay as far away from him as you can. If only... Look, whoever dreamt up the Dwarves' Law didn't think it through. Maybe it was meant to protect people, but what it really does is make everybody too afraid to stand up for themselves or challenge people in power, and Domitus knows that. He's next in line as Jarl of this place, so he gets his way by threatening to punish anyone who doesn't do what he wants. He's never physically hit anyone here, but the point is, he doesn't have to. I've seen him make grown men cry. Nords, they don't cry easily.
I cry most days. I think about leaving him, but where would I go? He says he'd make sure I wound up living in poverty again, like poor old Dooley. No, interfering will only make things worse. The only way you can help me is to find a way out of this city, or do something about the Dwarves' Law. I don't know if there's a way out or not, but there are places beneath this city nobody has ever explored. If I were you, I'd start with the tunnels. Well, I suppose that's all I can ask for. Funny, I was gonna ask you the same question. Alright, but we never had this chat, okay?
What do you want?
Say, you're wearing some of that immaculate dwarven armor. It's every bit as spectacular as they say. Be sure to show it to Brawl, and maybe Gaia.
The many shall suffer for the sins of the one.
you there? Where did you come from?
What are you talking about? I've never met you. You're right. I was. How could you have possibly known that? Is that some kind of sorcerer? Well, I don't want any trouble. Let me get out of your way. And let's forget this happened, shall we?
been waiting for you, Dovahkiin. Ah, I see you have not yet discovered your true nature. It seems I know you better than you know yourself. Of course, to me, your memories are an open tome. To begin with, I know you have taken a life in cold blood. And I know you have looted the corpses of those you have slain. I know you have slaughtered countless beasts of the wild in their natural habitats. I also know you have come from the future. And why is that? Is your desire for power so great that you would break even the laws of time for it? It makes no difference. You will not take it from me. You would not be so foolish as to break my law. I see the kind of person you are. My law is the only thing keeping you and your kind from descending into chaos. I mean, my law. I made it because your kind would be incapable of order, of peace, without it. That makes me the Arbiter. I am also the founder. I discovered this site millennia ago and the deposit of Aetherium beneath us. I laid the foundations and I watched my children grow and learn and use the Aetherium to create marvels, technological wonders. But they grew quarrelsome and used their knowledge to create weapons to use against their own kind, and worse, their own father. So I confiscated their weapons and declared my law that each and every one of my children would live in perfect order, or they would not live at all. And here I am, millennia later, still waiting for children worthy of this city. And for my patience, it seems my reward is a visit from you, Dovahkiin. Well, why have you traveled through time to come here? What is it you seek? If only you could read my memories as I read yours. Very well. Ask your questions. You wish to be ageless, like me. In truth, time passes differently in here. It would take an eternity just to explain it to you. Thousand years in your terms, but time is different down here. I count time in waves, generations, civilizations. You and your kind up above are number 322. It is not my place to reveal that secret to you, Dovahkiin. But when they moved on from this world, I was left behind. You see, the energy that has sustained me all this time, it anchored me here. I could not leave this place if I wanted to. You flock here, your kind, like moths to a flame, driven by greed and the lust for power. You are warned about my law, and when you disobey, and you always disobey, you force my hand, bringing death upon yourselves. So you ask if I am the one killing your kind, and I say no, you kill yourselves. I am merely the means by which you do it. So I see. Now, state your purpose here. You come here, hands stained in blood from the most vile of sins, without a noteworthy valorous act to your name. And you seek to lecture me in matters of law. I am not interested in hearing what you have to say. Your presence here aggrieves me. You will die. Impossible.
Must stop this from happening.
there. Where did you come from?
What are you talking about? I've never met you. You're right. I was. How could you have possibly known that? Is that some kind of sorcerer? Well, I don't want any trouble. Let me get out of your way. Let's forget this happened, shall we?
Waiting for you, Dovahkiin. Ah, I see you have not yet discovered your true nature. It seems I know you better than you know yourself. Of course, to me, your memories are an open tome. To begin with, I know you have taken a life in cold blood. And what's this? I see there is a helmet in your possession that does not belong to you. You kill me? That is not possible. And yet, I see you speak the truth. You have come unstuck. From your own time, your presence here is unnatural. Well then, Dovahkiin, why have you returned with this grim trophy? Have you come simply to gloat of your foul deed? Do you comprehend what you are asking me to do? You are asking me to abandon millennia of work. The very thought of it grieves me. And yet, you have left me with no choice, have you? If I agree, I will destroy my life's work. But if I refuse, you will destroy me. Well played, Dovahkiin. You will have your wish. I will stop. From this point forward, your kind will be free to live how they choose, in whatever chaos and squalor they create for themselves. I will destroy this Ethereum to ensure your kind can never exploit it, and you may all return to the world of man, should you wish. But I warn you, Dovahkiin, making these changes will create a paradox in time. The events that brought you here will never have taken place. What will become of you is difficult to predict. But that is the risk you have taken by interfering with the past. Now, are you ready? Goodbye, Dovahkiin.
Startled me there. Wait. I know you. You're... No, that can't be right. For a moment there, I thought you were... You know, the one the statue was meant to honor.
Cassia! Oh, I completely forgot. I asked her to wait for me at the top of the lift, and... I guess I got so tied up in this place that I lost track of time.
I'd better head back up and let her know I'm all right. Hey, do you want to come with me? We can chat along the way. Great. Follow me. Let's run back up, shall we? Don't want to keep my sister waiting any longer. So, you're probably wondering what I've been doing down here. I guess it's been, what, a few days? I'll be honest. I came down here looking for a haul I could unload on the next merchant I met. I just wasn't expecting to find a thriving city, and the history of this place is amazing. Did you know that up until about 7 years ago, they had what they called the Dwarves' Law? Apparently there were inscriptions warning that if one person committed a crime, everyone else would pay for it. But they were all trapped in the city with no way out. So they lived in fear that someone would break the law and get them all killed. Then, one day, a strange man appeared in the city out of nowhere. They say he just walked out of the lake house, like he owned the place. And he wore this spectacular dwarven armor. Not like the battered old stuff you see in the ruins. And a few people saw him walk into this quarry, into a field of deadly radiation, like it was nothing. Like it hadn't killed people before him. Then, the ground started shaking, and golden statues were collapsing, and inscriptions were crumbling all over the city, all at the same time. And the sun under the ground, which used to light up the entire cavern, bursts into flame and explodes. And strangest of all, the cavern roof opens up like the petals of a flower, and there's real sunlight for the first time in thousands of years. So of course, people start wondering, did he just walk down here and single-handedly dismantle whatever was keeping the Dwarves' Law going? Was he? Was he still alive? So Bro, the local scholar, goes down into the quarry to take a look. But now the whole place is empty. The bottom, sitting alone in the darkness, statue of the stranger. Oddest tale I ever heard.
What do you want? Better, now that I know I'm not being watched anymore. Still, someone has to protect this place, and that someone is me. So you might have taken down some old dwarves or whatever. But if you start any trouble here, you're going to find yourself toe-to-toe with me.
I remember you. You're back. After all this time. Can't complain, my friend. You know, not long after they executed Metallus, Turns out he was behind Macy's disappearance. They made me Jarl. It was a bit of a shock, to be honest. But I guess they wanted someone who wasn't at all like Metellus. Jarl Galvar. Still sounds strange to me. And I guess I have you to thank for it. If you hadn't freed us from the dwarves' laws, Ulrin could never have overthrown Metellus. So, thanks. I imagine you'll be moving on soon, but you'll always be welcome here. We even kept your chambers exactly as you left them.
Hi there.
Well, that's some beautiful armor you've got there. Well, let's see. That was 7 years ago? A lot has changed since then. For the better. I'm married to Gulvar now. Sorry. That's Jarl Gulvar. He still talks about you. And how he saw you come out of the old Jarl's lake house. You gave him a real fright. Though he wouldn't have showed it. I know he'd be happy to see you again. You should go and say hello, if you haven't already.
Hello, neighbor. Made any exciting new discoveries? Wonderful, actually. Gaia and I are still researching this place, of course. But now we get to share our research with the outside world. But I must ask, what happened down there, under the city? What did you do? You convinced him, you say? Well, if it is as you say, you must be terrifyingly persuasive. I only wish I could have been there to see it. I can see that you have somewhere else to be. But perhaps one day when you have the time, you'll let me record your story in my journal for posterity.
Have we met? Hi there. Better, thank you. You know, all that time I was looking after Brandis, I remember him telling me about the ancient evil under the earth. I really thought he was mad. But I guess he was right after all. Well, I'm glad you were able to finish what he started, whatever you did down there. So, on behalf of Brandis and Leandris, thank you. I like to think their souls are at rest now.
That armor, what I think it is? Oh, you wouldn't believe what a difference it's made. Habik and I finally felt safe enough to have another son. His name's Malik and he's six. He's just discovered his love for running. And fortunately, running isn't something Habik and I have to do anymore. We're safe here. I have no idea what you did to bring an end to the Dwarves' Law, but whatever it was, thank you so much. We'll never forget you.
Sorry, Cass. I lost track of time again. It's just that this city is so amazing. You have to come down with me and see it for yourself. I promise. It's perfectly safe.
Well, all right. But first, let me thank our friend. Now, I promised you a reward. This is something I always carry with me, and it's become very dear to me. I'd like you to have it. Thanks again. My brother and I are in your debt.
While preparing for my lecture, these two were brought in.
found in the sewers. Sinechuklawan washinechti. There is no external evidence of cause of death, but I can tell you that their souls were taken. The glow of my Nasena, the soul trap spells, is faint, but it still lingers. There is no need. The spell's signature tells me everything I need to know about who has done this. Every mage has a unique way of casting a spell. Naturally, we cannot know them all, but this signature I know too well. I know the murderer. I am ashamed to say he was a pupil of mine along with the headmistress here. They were classmates. It seems so. The headmistress is out searching for him now, though I begged her not to go. I am sorry, but this is a sensitive matter and not my business to discuss further. The headmistress will have to handle it herself.
Yes, I'm giving a lecture on life extension and the magical arts. Attend if you like. Good day.
I only just arrived myself. I heard her say something about Shadow Falls, but now is hardly the time to go looking for her. Wouldn't you agree? Vantril Grim. I remember him. Kind and innocent in front of the teachers and the pretty girls. But he was a vile data spawn. I am not at all surprised to find him wrapped up in all of this. Don't thank me. If you see Vantril Grimoire, you'd better run the other way.
Yes, be seated. Now then, I will start with a question. Which race produces the most powerful mages currently active on Nirn? Ha! Surprisingly to the uninitiated, it is not a race of mare or men at all. It is not a humanoid beast race, nor is it you. The key vectors in achieving mastery of magic lie in natural talent, length of study, and motivation. For the first two, no race still active on all of Nirn has greater natural talent or time to devote to study than the mighty dragons. Dragons are considered to be lesser Aedra, but then so could all the races of Nirn. All of us contain a spark of the divine clothed in flesh. There is much debate as to the true origins of the races. Myths and stories tend to be both contradictory and entirely true. further, the hypothesis that dragons cannot reproduce sexually or be killed without returning is also highly disputed. Reports of dragon eggs and infant dragons go back thousands of years. It is said that the greatest masters of the Thum can resurrect a dead dragon. In this very school, you will find a half dozen mages easily capable of reanimating a corpse. The point is, death need not be forever. It is, however, horribly inconvenient. As to achieving mastery of magicka, no other race currently active on Nirn, except perhaps the Hist, can claim natural talent or lifespans matching those of the dragons. Only in motivation can the short-lived races of Nirn, particularly the men, hope to compete with the mare or the mighty dragons. Finally, we come to the solution to the problem of mortality, at least for men. Undeath. Specifically, lichdom and vampirism. Indeed, there are other means to achieve something closer to physical immortality. But those are far more difficult. For the mage who does not wish to end his studies, vampirism is a viable option. A vampire may continue to study until physically destroyed. And unlike the leech, a vampire may maintain his original personality and appearance, more or less. While it is true that madness often follows crude infection with sanguinaris vampiris, when the change is intentional and well planned, there is no reason for a trained mind to go mad. I will provide you with study material relevant to the topic at hand. This is a school, and it is my responsibility to provide information. It is your own responsibility to decide what you do with that information. Thank you, and good morrow.
Yes, yes, I haven't got all day.
Yes.
Make it quick.
Of course, young one. There are many things I can teach you.